Oh, it's an exciting one. So there has been a recent software update to Tesla Autopilot that has added actual little walking leg animations. So previously when pedestrians were displayed on this little map, they were just little mannequins where their legs didn't move, but apparently now their legs move. It doesn't make you drive any better, but it should look cool. So we're basically on the hunt for some pedestrians today. So we're gonna head to a few different locations and hope that we can get some people to walk in front of us. We've got some pedestrians coming up on the path on the left, but generally they don't always show up unless they're actually on the road. But you never know, they might show up, so I guess we'll see. Oh my God! That is so weird. That is, what on earth? That is so strange. Oh my God, that looked so weird, didn't it? Hopefully we can get to the front of some traffic lights and we can get some people walk right in front of us so that we can see them cross in front of the car. But also later in this video, Becky will be walking around the car. She'll be running backwards and forwards, changing direction, and we can just see how that is displayed on the map because it is always interesting to see. So we're inside Tesco's car park and we're gonna be very nice. We're gonna let anyone that potentially wants to walk in front of us just go ahead. So hopefully we'll see some people. What's interesting is we're going over a zebra crossing right now, but we have people's legs dangling about before we have zebra crossings showing up on the visualization, which seems like a strange decision to me. All right, there's people queuing here, so I'm curious to see if any of them will show up. We'll just go slow, I suppose. Oh, there we go, there we go. This lady's showing up. Oh my God, that looks really, really creepy, doesn't it? Okay, Tesco employee, we're heading down. Does he show up? Oh, there he is. So he was going the wrong way. That was not accurate to his direction. We've got another person here. It's a zebra crossing. Oh, we see them perfectly. Trolley does not show up.
Look at her legs.
All right, that is mad. Oh, it thinks she's two people for a second. Oh, that's really weird. That is so strange. Okay, we're looping past these people a second time. Oh, this guy's just blissfully walked out in front of the road. This is perfect. Thank you so much. Thank you for not teaching your child to look both ways before crossing. That is perfect for my YouTube video. That was some cracking footage that we just got. I think it's time to get ourselves to BMQ. Oh my God, this is perfect. We've got a live one. We've got a couple of live ones right there. Hey guys, do you want to cross the road in front of me? No, they didn't show up at all, which is a bit of a shame. Oh, there they go. They showed up for a second, going the wrong direction. Oh my God, there's people everywhere. Look at that. Oh, what a dream. Oh, here we go, here we go. We've got some live ones on both sides. Oh, it's all happening. They showed up just for a second. Here we go, there's some more. So they're kind of flickering on and off on the map. That walking animation is really bizarre, isn't it? That is so strange. So that's very weird, to be honest. Like I said, it's strange that we've got legs moving around before we have other things popping up on the driver visualization, like zebra crossings and those sort of things. But either way, it is just a cool thing. It's not gonna make me drive any better. If anything, I'm probably gonna be slightly more distracted, to be honest. But it looks very cool nonetheless, and I'm really impressed with it. So I think what we're gonna do now is we're gonna head to a nice private spot where we can just get Becky to run around the car. But also, because this is a software update, I have noticed quite significant improvements to Autopilot. So we'll do a little bit of Autopilot testing while we're on the way there. Okay, we're gonna enable Autopilot right now in this 30 zone. So the car is now driving itself completely. We are coming up to a 60, which is just a little bit further away. So while there's no cars right behind me, I want to see if it updates the speed automatically or if I have to actually intervene. So you can see the 60 is coming up now. At what point is this going to change to 30? Oh, 60, sorry. So it's just changed now, but it hasn't updated. So I have to click that. Now we'll start accelerating up to 60 miles an hour, which seems a little bit odd to me. I think it'd be okay if perhaps you had to click this button to update the speed, but the fact that you have to click there, which is in a bit of an awkward spot, seems a little bit odd. But anyway, we are now accelerating up to 60 miles an hour, and the car is doing all of this by itself. So it's keeping us on 59 while we go around that corner. So I've only driven the car once since the latest software update. And the thing that I noticed was that it slowed down around corners in a way where it didn't before, which is something that we've complained about in quite a few videos. We just have a cyclist coming up, so I just want to see what the car does here. So it's going quite quick, so I am just going to slow down, I think, just because it's not worth any kind of risk. But you can see he's showing up nicely on the map, and we can now accelerate around him. And we'll get Autopilot back on. So we're approaching a couple of really tight corners, which previously Autopilot didn't slow down at all, and I had to just take over because you should really not do those corners at 60. But I just want to see, will it slow down itself this time, or will I have to take over? Here we go, this is it. Is it going to slow down at all? It's not. Oh, it is slowing down. Oh, it's doing it all itself. I'm touching the wheel, but that's just for safety measures. Yeah, it slowed down. See, it's never done that before. It was a little bit scary, you should see Becky's face. So it took us down to 40, and now we're out of those two corners, and it's slowly accelerating by up to 60. But I'm really pleased with that. This corner coming up as well, it previously didn't slow down for this corner, so let's find out if it slows down for this corner this time. Once again, I am holding the wheel, but I'm not doing anything. And as you can see, it's took us down to 50 miles an hour, 48, 47. Getting around the corner safely. It's doing this completely by itself.
Smashed it.
And it nailed that. I'd say the last one, it went a little bit too quickly right at the beginning and then sorted itself out. Whereas that one, I'd say it was perfect. But I have to take over because we've just gone into a 30 and it was still doing 60. And for some reason, it thinks that this is a 40 zone as well, even though this is a 30 zone. Right, let's turn it back on. So it's gone down to 40 max, so I'm gonna have to manually change it to 30. This is a little bit of a tight corner, so we may as well see how it gets on. And we're much slower speed, so I'm more confident just doing that. It's warning me to be prepared to take over, but it did nail the corner. This is some really impressive autopilot so far. This update's made a massive difference. Right. Turn autopilot back on, and hey, have you subscribed to the channel yet? Please do that, we upload at least once a week, do appreciate it. So this is a 30 zone, quiet roads, no cars parked on the side, so this is absolutely fine for autopilot. But we're about to go into a 40, which then turns into a 60, and there is a tight corner, so we can see how the car gets on there, and we can see how it changes the speeds by itself. So we're still in the 30 zone, but we're going into the 40 zone now. So you can see that it's updated, it thinks we're in a 60 zone now, but we're not, we're in a 40 zone, and plus it hasn't changed our speed. It's keeping our speed on 30, and I've now been in 30 for a long time, and it's still not changed anything. It's going around this corner nicely. And we're getting into the 60, so I'm just going to click this and it should start accelerating us. Interestingly, it thinks we're now in a 40. Oh, it's just up there. Now it thinks we're in a 60. So we've got another very scary turning that's just a little bit further up here, which we're going to try on autopilot, but I think I'll reduce us down to 50 preemptively, just because it is quite a tight and blind corner. All right, we should be able to turn autopilot on because of these lanes. So there it is. And then I'm going to reduce us down to... Oh, bless you, Becky.
Thank you.
Here's the corner. I've reduced us to 50. It did it. It didn't do it very well, but it did do it. It gave us a little beep as well. So I kept... That was very strange. Did you see that?
Okay, so just to break down exactly what just happened after reviewing the footage. Tesla autopilot successfully made it around the corner. It did beep at me to let me know that I need to be prepared to take over just in case. But then, once we made it around the corner, I nudged the wheel just to tell autopilot that I'm still paying attention. But I nudged it too harshly, which actually took us out of autopilot. I didn't realize we weren't in autopilot, so we started drifting into the hedge on the left. Fortunately, because of Tesla's lane departure avoidance system, it beeped at me warning me that we were drifting, and I was able to grab the wheel before any damage was done to the car. So I'd say what happened there was actually my fault and the Tesla actually saved us. But if you disagree, let me know down in the comments.
We've got another really tight corner coming up, so I'm just going to put us back onto autopilot. I'll maybe slow us down to 50. Yeah, we'll go 50. So right now it's keeping us at 30 and it's still decelerating. It's slowing down slower and slower. What's happening right now? I've set it to 51, but it's slowed us down to 20, 19. It's going around the corner. We're a bit close to the side there. Didn't do that very well at all. I'll turn it back on and see how it gets on. Okay, it's managing this corner, but it is going slow. But I suppose 20 is a reasonable speed to go. Okay, will it speed back up to somewhere close to 50 now? It might have to slow down a little bit here. No, it's speeding back up as normal. It felt like it was decelerating a little too slow, but perhaps that's because it could see that I'd slowed the speed down a little bit, so it just maybe wanted to see what I was doing. I don't know. So let us know down in the comments. Right now we can see people walking around, we can see cones, we can see stop signs, we can see other cars and vehicles, we can even see bollards. But what do you think the next thing that you should be able to see on the driver visualizations should be? I feel like zebra crossings and those kind of things is probably going to be a bit of a big one. Oh, we've reached our destination, so I'll put the car in park. And now, Becky gets to run around the car. I'm hyped for this. There she is. Hey, Becky, I just got my car cleaned. Can you please show how shiny it is before?
Yeah, it looks amazing. Look at the wheels.
Shiny. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and put the car into drive. Oh, and we can immediately see that Becky is right there. Becky, please just walk in front of the car if you don't mind. Oh, so she's disappeared. We saw one leg movement and then she disappeared. So when you stood still, the car does this annoying thing where it kind of changes the POV. Could you walk down the road, Becky? So I might have to keep my finger there. Oh, there she goes. She's off. She's disappeared again. There's no cars nearby, so I'm going to drive towards her. And we'll just see if she shows up or not. There she is. Can I ask you to jog towards me? Oh, here she comes. No, nothing at all. You're going to have to jog again, I'm afraid. Try and jog better, Becky. All right, here we go. She's going for it. Oh, there she is. That was good, Becky, but not good enough, really. I might have to get you to go again. Oh, there she goes. Oh, that looks pretty good. That was better. It's getting better each time. So it's not as reliable as I was hoping. I was hoping that she literally just would stay 100% on screen, and if she moved back and forwards, we'd see that. But it doesn't seem like that's going to happen. It seems like it's a little bit more flashing on and off. We've got a couple of cyclists about to go past, so let's see if they show up on the map. Okay, there they go. Oh, there we go. So we see him from a great distance. Two cyclists seem to only ever show up as one cyclist, though. Right, we're going to swap, and we'll see if I show up any better than Becky. All right, I'm going to just have a little run about and we'll see if anything shows up. Anything?
Nothing at all.
I'll go again.
There you are.
Was it see me?
There he is.
Hey, I was picking my nose. I hope it didn't pick that up.
Oh, you've gone. It was good while it lasted.
Yeah, but how nice was that for like a second?
It was incredible. Go again. Go again.
Right, here we go.
There you are!
Still there?
Yeah. Wait, let me just zoom in a bit. Keep going back and forth there.
Oh, no way.
That looks so good.
What if I jump around?
It just carries on with the weird walking motion, but it's just... Oh, you've gone. You've gone. You're back again.
Tell me when I'm reliably showing up and then I'm going to lie on the floor.
Okay. Now! Yeah, but you just stood up. Woo. Oh.
What if I walk backwards?
Yeah, it's just walking backwards. It's just got you stood still all the way over there still.
Oh, that's very weird.
Mm.
Oh, I turned into a car.
Oh, now you're a car. Interesting.
That is odd. Oh, I'm back in the driver's seat. Okay, here we go. Oh, yeah. So that was really interesting, actually. I really enjoyed testing that, and I'm sure it'll just improve and the animations will get more accurate. But once again, let me know what you think the next animation to appear on the screen should be in a future update. Now, before we end off... God, I'm tired. Before we end off, a while ago, we tested stop signs, and it seemed a bit weird because we had our own little stop sign, and it just showed up really tiny on the map. But we have discovered that there is an actual real stop sign just a little bit up the road. So, Becky, if you wouldn't mind filming the screen, you can see our stop sign in the distance, and it should just start. There it is. It's shown up on the map. So that's kind of like what our stop sign showed up as. But if we get quite a bit closer, you'll see that it actually shows up really, really clearly on the map. And we can stop there, and there's our stop sign. We can see that it says stop perfectly. So this basically proves a lot of your assumptions in our stop sign video, was that because our stop sign was quite a bit smaller, the Tesla thought that the stop sign was a lot further away than it actually was. I didn't think of this when we filmed it, but a lot of people did point out in the comments. All right, on that note, I'm gonna end off this video. Hopefully you enjoy it. I absolutely love when these kind of features come out because it's just a really nice, fun thing to test and mess about with. Hopefully you enjoyed it too. We are uploading at least once a week, so if you're interested in Teslas and Model 3s and all of the software updates, please do subscribe because it's completely free. And you can just unsubscribe if you change your mind. Thanks for watching. Thank you, Becky, for your help, and I'll see you all later.